We saw a little bit of everything today. Long breaks of sunshine, a few clouds and some showers in some suburbs. It reached a top of 15 degrees in Terry Hills, 17 in Penrith, Parramatta and Campbelltown, and a top of 18 degrees in the city. That's 2 degrees warmer than average. We saw some showers along the New South Wales coast today, 17 millimetres falling in Ballina, 11 in Jervis Bay and 10 millimetres in Nowra. Today we saw top temperatures a little above average, reaching 17 in Newcastle, Griffith, Wollongong, Albury and in Bega. Tomorrow, tropical moisture will stream into western Queensland and South Australia, bringing heavy rain and storms, while a firm high pressure will keep Victoria, Tasmania and most of New South Wales dry. Brisbane will be partly cloudy tomorrow, heading for 21, fine and 14 in Canberra, cloudy and heading for a top of 13 in Melbourne. More light showers are expected along the New South Wales coast tomorrow, the heaviest rain concentrated around Coffs Harbour. Inland areas staying dry and mostly sunny, heading for 13 in Bathurst, 17 in Dubbo and in Wagga Wagga. Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow. There is a high chance of some light showers and light to moderate southerly winds. If that rain arrives, we'll see 1 to 5 millimetres of rain fall in the city and 2 to 5 millimetres across our west. We are heading for tops of around 16 degrees for most of our western suburbs. That's 2 degrees cooler than average, while the city is heading for 18 degrees. That's actually 2 degrees warmer than average. Let's take a look ahead. The weekend should be mostly dry. Just a possible shower or two on each day with a top of 18 degrees. Those showers lingering early next week, but only bringing a few millimetres of rain, if anything, before drying out on Wednesday. Those top temperatures staying above average, hovering around 18 to 19 degrees, while nights will range from 12 down to 9 degrees. In our west, a possible shower on Saturday, but it will only be a millimetre or two, if anything. Fine on Sunday with a top of 17, with just a few light showers early next week, before fining up and warming up next Wednesday. Those nights range from 7 to 10 degrees, Pete.
Hello again from the Moama Lights. The twin towns of Echuca Moama host this very special winter event as the traditional colours of the Murray are transformed by a spectacular light and sound show. You're taken into a completely different world as you walk through the thousands of illuminated images of native flowers and animals, artwork by local children and Indigenous artists. A 600 metre trail leading to the Moama Wharf bursts into colour in a theme inspired by Banjo Paterson's poem, The Daylight is Dying. Depicting the transformation nature makes as twilight descends, this is such a family-friendly destination. During the day, this region has more sunshine than the Gold Coast and it's full of school holiday fun. Echuca is also feeling the morning chill. It dipped below zero this morning, but it's been a glorious sunny day and warmed up to 16.3. The city had a much colder day, only reaching 11.9 after a low of 1.3. Most suburbs were even colder, -2 at Epping, -1 at Ringwood. And further out, Rutherglen plummeted to -2 before rebounding to be the warmest spot in the state, 19 degrees. It was a cooler day in the south, just 11 at Ballarat. Tomorrow, a high-pressure system will continue to bring settled conditions, which means another cold morning. A frost warning is in place for the Wimmera and northern districts. Shepparton and Wodonga are heading down to -1, and there'll be areas of morning fog. But once again, the payoff will be sunny skies, with maximums of 15, 16 or 17 degrees in the north, a bit cooler through the south. Melbourne can expect some morning fog, but it won't be as chilly as the past 2 days. Mostly 5 degrees, 2 at Fernie Creek, 3 at Scoresby. At the other end of the day, it's heading for 12, 13 or 14 under cloudy skies and light winds. Geelong should get some breaks of sunshine, a low of 6 and a top of 14. But after a low of 5, the city's only expected to make it to 13 under cloudy skies. Then a dry weekend, but some colder mornings. A low of 3 on Saturday before a mostly sunny afternoon, a maximum of 12. Down to 1 on Sunday, then a top of 15. Up to 17 on Monday with light showers in the evening. They'll stick around Tuesday with up to 7 millimetres. Cloudy and 15 on Wednesday and 15 again next Thursday with a shower or two. Alicia and Tom, thanks to Visit Victoria. We've shown you some beautiful pictures of the lights here, but they really do need to be experienced firsthand. They are just magical. And a special school holiday treat Thursdays to Sunday until the end of July.
Oh, I'm afraid it will be, Andrew. It certainly won't dampen the spirits of the 50,000 plus people expected to attend over the weekend. 30,000 participants will cross the finish line over the weekend, considering this event started in 1979 with only just over 600 participants. But it will be a great, and it certainly will be a big weekend. Some heavy falls Saturday morning early for the start of the half marathon, and a few showers for the full marathon on Sunday morning. A little bit of drizzle here at the moment on the Gold Coast. Let's have a quick look at your radar. You will see the showers persistent along the coast today. Heaviest falls once again have been out around North Stradbroke, up to 49 millimetres, but even the Golden Sunshine Coast getting a bit of a soaking today. On to temperatures quickly, and lows of 8 degrees in Oakey, 9 in Toowoomba, 12 in Ipswich. The max today, 22 at Archerfield in Ipswich, 21 in Brizzy, 20 for Redcliffe, and here on the Goldie, 19 the Sunshine Coast. To the weather map, tropical moisture filtering down through Western Queensland, the Northern Territory, also through New South Wales and South Australia will bring some heavy rain and storms. Onshore winds will continue along the east coast, delivering those showers. For the capitals, sunny in Perth and Adelaide, cloudy cool Melbourne and Hobart, showers in Sydney, early frost in Alice Springs, sunny and 31 for Darwin. Queensland showers, Cairns, Townsville and Mackay, mostly sunny for Rocky and Gladstone, also Bundy tomorrow, shower or two for Maryborough and Gympie, afternoon shower possibly Mount Isa, but fine and mostly sunny Longreach and Roma. Here in the southeast, there'll certainly be some cloud, particularly the coast. That's where most of the showers will be, in some gusty southeasterly winds. Daytime temperatures tomorrow between 17 and 21. Moreton Bay, the southerlies, 15, even up to 25 knots. That's why most of the showers are on the coast and bay islands. Brisbane, mostly sunny morning, chance of a late shower, a top of 21. But the outlook, your weekend, shower or two Saturday, Sunday, cloudy, scattered showers Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, daytime temperatures in the low 20s. Ipswich, possible light shower or two over the weekend, a few showers Monday, increasing for Tuesday and hanging around into Wednesday. Here on the Goldie, wet for Saturday for the Gold Coast Marathon, scattered showers Sunday, Monday, heavier falls Tuesday and Wednesday. Sunshine Coast, a wet weekend, up to 10 millimetres Saturday, 2 to 10 millimetres Sunday, cloudy with scattered showers, 5 to 10 millimetres possible Monday, Tuesday and also Wednesday. So a busy weekend on the Gold Coast. The event itself, there will be some road closures anywhere north of here up to around Paradise Point, all the way down to around Miami. So just prepare for that if you're on the Goldie over the weekend. Have a great Friday.
Hello again. It's a cold night, but the fires are keeping us warm here at the Botanic Garden as Illuminate Festival lights up the night around Adelaide. 17 degrees in the city today and around the suburbs. It was a much more bearable than yesterday with those overnight lows, only dipping to around 6 and 7 degrees overnight. We made 18 degrees at Mawson Lakes. A few showers through the west of the state today, but dry through the south and again into the minuses through the southeast. On the charts, a high pressure system is still in charge, but there is a trough generating the odd sprinkle too. Interstate tomorrow, Melbourne on the cloudy side, expecting 13 degrees. Brisbane warmer with 21. Back home, there are some showers around our north and west tomorrow, so Juna could see a bit, but drier for Port Augusta and Port Pirie with 19. A sunny day for Renmark, shooting for 18 degrees, and a mixture of cloud and sun through the south, with Mount Gambier expecting 15. We still have a frost warning in place for the lower southeast, freezing temperatures there again, while out west and along central coastlines we're looking at strong wind warnings, so take care by the water. Much calmer along the Adelaide coastline, easterlies 10 to 15 knots and seas below a metre. Now it's a lovely looking Friday around Adelaide tomorrow. 17 degrees for Elizabeth, Glenelg and Marion. It might start out a little bit cloudy, but clearing up to 17 degrees in the city. Saturday looks great too. 17 degrees, clear skies, just a slight chance of a shower on Sunday, but as far as festivals go, fantastic conditions for Illuminate.